This is Paul Turner, the immigration barrister to Imperium Chambers. Please subscribe to my channel and help me hit my target of 3,000 subscribers as I bring you up-to-date immigration news and opinions. Today, I return to a familiar topic, which is the need for the a UK immigration amnesty. And I put it to Priti Patel that there needs to be one. I have talked about this for a while now, and direct this video directly to the Secretary of State for the Home Department. The Prime Minister has spoken out in favour of an amnesty for years before becoming Prime Minister. So why has it not happened? Particularly as now that the country is in the grip of the worst pandemic this century. The reasons for an amnesty previously were based upon the usefulness to the economy of having undocumented migrants bought into the economy. Now it is in the interest of the nation, given the coronavirus pandemic. Please share this video widely and contact your MP. Firstly, there is the issue of public health. We are in the middle of a pandemic. The numbers are increasing. Unlike Italy, which had an amnesty, the UK government continues with the hostile environment, which only serves to encourage the spread of the virus. This means with more restrictions on people, that those here undocumented are forced to either starve or work, and if they go out and work, they risk their lives and risk spreading the virus. Unfortunately, for the government, the coronavirus does not discriminate. This therefore affects not only the undocumented in the United Kingdom, but the population generally. If that wasn't enough, then one has to look at the Home Office's performance to see whether it's doing its job properly. Sadly, the Home Office is in disarray, to put it mildly. Priti Patel herself has admitted that the asylum system is fundamentally broken. For a start, the Home Office does not even know how many people are in the United Kingdom, illegally or even legally for that matter. Further, the National Audit Office said that the Home Office spent 390 million people on removing just over about 10,000 people a year. Therefore, there is no realistic prospect of ever removing a million people. The hostile environment led to the Windrush scandal, where people legally entitled to be in the United Kingdom were detained and in some cases removed unlawfully. Of the 30 recommendations made in the Windrush Lessons Learned review, there is no sign of them being implemented or any timescale for their implementation. And the writer of the report was scathing in the Home Office's failure to act promptly. The government continues to stop migrants entering the United Kingdom. The number of refugees is increasing. The waiting times for asylum seekers are increasing. Refugees, and last year over half of the people that claimed asylum were granted some form of status at the initial stage, so they're not all bogus, are being kept in appalling conditions at which risk them catching and spreading COVID-19. Modern day slavery continues in the United Kingdom despite 10 years of trying to eradicate it. And while we have a large number of undocumented migrants who want to live, want a better way of life and who are scared of the police, this problem will continue to exist and the people that prey on these people will continue to be able to do so. Some 50,000 students had their visas curtailed, falling victim to the government entrusting English language testing to ETS, which has led to people struggling for 5 years or more to clear their name. The end of the transition period post-Brexit is coming very, very soon, and many thousands of EU nationals have not yet applied for the status they're entitled to, and they therefore risk becoming overstayers sometime in early next year. The Home Secretary has talked of a humane and fair immigration policy. The system is clearly rotten. We are in the middle of a pandemic, the like of which I've not seen in my lifetime. And yet all that's happened is tinkering around the edges. It won't do. The new PBS is not going to deal with the problem. It's not going to deal with the undocumented migrants. It's certainly not going to deal with the problems posed by coronavirus. Only an amnesty, as pushed for by Boris Johnson, and a radical overhaul of how the Home Office works and the need for migration will work. The time for playing politics with migrants' lives is over, given that the legal and illegal are both prey to the coronavirus pandemic. Quite simply, there is no more us and them. We are all in the same situation together. And having a large number of undocumented people in the country scared to go to the authorities will only prolong the nation's suffering. Therefore, an amnesty for the people here, a radical overhaul of the system is desperately required. This is Paul Turner. I hope to have a response from the Secretary of State or some form of engagement. Please pass this video on or share it, and please put pressure on your MP to push this matter forward. These are desperate times and desperate measures need to be taken. Italy took them. It gave the 600,000 people that were there illegally and helping the country status, therefore bringing them into the fold. Italy has considerably fewer coronavirus cases than the United Kingdom. Facts speak for themselves. Why this government ignores them is another matter. Anyway, thank you for watching. This is Paul Turner, the immigration barrister at Imperium Chambers.